Hello students, welcome back to the new video. In the previous video, we have learnt about the cell and its structure and various parts of the cell. Now in this video, I am going to explain you the difference between the cell membrane and the cell wall. Actually, the cell membrane and the cell wall is basically the outermost covering of the cell. Every living cell has an outermost layer, and in the case of animal cell, the cell membrane is the outermost skin layer of the, and in case of plant cell, the cell wall is the outermost covering of the cell, and in between there is a plasma membrane or a cell membrane. So we can say that the cell membrane is found both in plants and in animal cell, whereas you will find cell wall only in the plant cell. And the nature of the cell membrane is very flexible, that it can be compressed easily or can stretch, whereas in case of cell wall, it is very rigid. That's why it gives a fixed shape to the cell. So we can learn that the second point is flexible and the cell wall is rigid. Now the third point between the cell membrane and the cell wall is the permeability. Now the cell membrane is a selectively permeable membrane. Now we should understand what do you mean by a selectively permeable membrane and what do you mean by a fully permeable membrane. Actually, permeability means when we allow something to pass in or out of the cell. Permeability means a method of passing something in the cell or that is something coming out of the cell. So if a cell is fully permeable, if a wall of the cell is fully permeable, permeable means anything can go in the cell or anything can come out of the cell easily. Whereas if we talk about a selectively permeable membrane, then it means only the selective things, either it could be a good, it could be a high concentration to low concentration, only selective, some ions, some proteins, some minerals, that is allowed to enter into the cell and everything cannot pass into it. So we can say the cell membrane is very choosy and it allows only selective things to enter into the cell, whereas a cell wall is not so choosy, so it allows everything to go in the cell and to come out of the cell. So the last point between there is the composition. The cell membrane is made up of lipids and protein. A very, very important question, and it can come in the MCQs also. The cell membrane is made up of lipids and proteins. These are the two components required to make a cell membrane. Whereas a cell wall is made up of only cellulose. So cellulose is like a complex molecule of a starch, so we can say it's a very, very complex molecule and it is very hard also. So cell wall consists of cellulose. So you should learn these difference between and note down in your notes also. Now we talk about how the cell membrane and the cell wall follows different method of transportation in the cell. How the substances go in the cell and they come out of the cell. So there are two methods, osmosis and diffusion. Osmosis and diffusion are the two main basic methods that occurs in the cell transportation. So we learn the difference between the osmosis and diffusion. As we have done in the previous classes also, we will start with the diffusion. This method is followed by all the solid, liquid and gaseous substance. So this method is not fixed for only one type of material or only one type of matter. Anything that can be diffused from high concentration to low concentration, whereas in case of osmosis, followed by only liquid medium. तो अभी हमें ये समझ में आ रहा है कि जो diffusion और osmosis दो methods होते हैं जिनसे material transfer किया जाता है cell के अंदर या बाहर, अब उसमें से डिफ्यूजन सॉलिड चीजों का भी हो सकता है, लिक्विड का भी हो सकता है और गैसियस चीजों का भी हो सकता है, जबकि ऑस्मोसिस मेथड हमेशा लिक्विड मीडियम में ही फॉलो किया जाता है। ऑस्मोसिस हमेशा लिक्विड सब्सटेंसेस का होता है। नाउ सेमी परमिएबल मेम्ब्रेन इज रिक्वायर्ड इन द केस ऑफ ऑस्मोसिस। ऑस्मोसिस में एक बीच में सेमी परमिएबल मेम्ब्रेन की जरूरत पड़ती है। मेम्ब्रेन के फ्रॉम वन साइड टू द अदर साइड ऑफ द मेम्ब्रेन द मटीरियल और अ लिक्विड इज ट्रांसफर्ड, वेयर एज नो सेमी परमिएबल मेम्ब्रेन इज रिक्वायर्ड इन द केस ऑफ डिफ्यूजन। Is required in this case. No semi-permeable membrane is required, whereas semi-permeable membrane is required. So diffusion involves the movement of solvent particles. Osmosis involves the movement of solvent particle, whereas diffusion involves the movement of solute particles. Now we understand this thing with the help of this diagram. Like I have made a container that contains a fluid. Fluid contains, these are the solute particles. Now these solute particles could be of anything like a sugar or salt or any color particles. Now we can see that if we drop an ink drop at one corner of the container, then the particles will get scattered like this. Then this is a high concentration area. Number of particles are higher in this area, but slowly what happens? Particle starts moving towards the lower concentration area, and when they start spreading, and after some time then the concentration of whole solution will become equal and then the movement of particle will stop. So this is actually called a diffusion. And if there is a semi-permeable membrane created in between this, then the particle start moving from this semi-permeable membrane, then the particle will start moving from the pores of this semi-permeable membrane, then we call it a osmosis. So here is the two processes, like a diffusion and osmosis. Normally carbon dioxide and oxygen diffuses into the cell by the method of diffusion, and liquid or water moves into the cell and out of the cell with the help of osmosis. So these are the two. If somebody asks you the question, what is the two different, how is the carbon dioxide or oxygen get transported in the cell? So you just have to write that the carbon dioxide and oxygen are the two gases. So gases always diffuse, and whereas water moves with the process of osmosis in the cell, in and out of the cell. So this is what we have to learn today, and see you in the next video with the new topic, three types of solutions. Thank you guys.